I'm Sttowe here, and today we're going to be going over my monthly pickups of January 2023. Stick around because this is the most amount of money I've ever spent on a single month. I literally just shit everywhere. So before I get right into this, I just gotta say again, this is the most expensive month that I've ever just spent on Pokemon cards. I nearly dropped $400. I'll tell you the exact amount at the end of this video, but I basically treated this like Christmas almost because this was my Christmas in January. But starting off, we got the Umbreon V Trainer Gallery from Brilliant Stars. This card on TCG Player goes for $16.28. I paid $17, and this is something you're going to notice with a lot of my purchases today. A lot of these cards I bought towards the end of Christmas, which was early January in the new year. Basically, you know, Christmas time, cards are at their highest ceiling. They're most expensive because everyone wants to buy them for their kids, family, friends, all that great stuff. But basically, when I got this card, I think it was around like $20. So it's gone down in price. As I kind of expected, most of these Pokemon cards should be going down now that Christmas is over and we're going into the summer. So I imagine that all these cards should be going down in value, which I guess is kind of my fault for buying it as of like January, but I figured, fuck it, I need these cards. Now, the Umbreon V, this is the final card that I needed for my Brilliant Stars Trainer Gallery set, so just glad I can get this, and this was honestly in really good condition. So now we have six cards I got from another person, paid $75 for all six. The first one I will show is Khalil. I don't know how to say his name, but she looks like she's gonna beat the shit out of my dick with this golf club.
Pick it up. Pick it up.
Anyways, this is a full art trainer from Lost Thunder, which is a Sun and Moon set. Goes for about $19.74. So a pretty pricey card, but still a gorgeous one at that, a little bit off center, but in really decent condition, and it's practically near mint. So this is a card I really wanted. Again, Sun and Moon, it's an older type of card, so I figured you got to get these now while they're still cheap. Sun and Moon, XY, full art trainers, they're still cheap. Get them now while you can. The next one we got, I'll just put this to the side, is Winona. I don't know, but she looks pretty badass. She's a full art trainer from Roaring Skies, which is an XY set. A little bit of whitening up at the top. Not too big a fan, but the centering is nice. And it's in really good condition, which is kind of hard with a lot of XY cards. This card goes for $18.65. Almost had a heart attack trying to say that. But again, just another gorgeous full art trainer that I needed for my collection. The next card we got is a Gallade V Trainer Gallery card from Lost Origin. This card goes for $5.19. Just another Trainer Gallery card that I needed for my collection. I did not pull this in Lost Origin. I pulled kind of jack shit if you want to look at my previous videos. But Lost Origin is seeming to go up in price as it's getting harder and harder to find. I don't know if this is really true. This is what a lot of YouTubers are saying. But I'll let you know. If you just go onto the Pokemon Center, you'll be able to find Lost Origin, Silver Tempest, Estral Radiance, Brilliant Stars. You'll find them all. So I don't know why a lot of YouTubers are saying that it's hard to find. But, you know, I think you can easily get it on the Pokemon Center. Next, we got Lysander Full Art. This one is from Flash Fire, which is another XY set. Now, this card, oh my god.
Oh my god.
What a gorgeous Full Art trainer this is. Lysander is such a badass. And I like him as an antagonist. I think he's a pretty good villain. This is in really good condition, which is hard to find. A lot of Lysander cards that I'm finding are, you know, in like rough beat up condition. So this one currently goes for $18.56 on TCG Player. But I tell you, if you go on to eBay, you won't be able to find like this card in good near mint condition under $20. It is really tough to find this card. So just glad I got it when I did. Next, we have Ice Rider Calyrex V. Honestly, not a fan of this card. This card, like, I don't like this, like, weird art style, 3D. I don't know. It just, to me, it doesn't look too nice. But again, I needed this for my set. It's a Trainer Gallery card from Astral Radiance, and it goes for $6.73. Last but not least, Eternatus V. Another Trainer Gallery card from Lost Origin. Goes for $5.49. Just another card that I really needed, and it's in really nice condition. So those six cards that I just shown, I paid $75 for. Altogether, the value is $74.36. So again, under the value by not even a dollar. But at the time, these cards were around like, altogether was like an $85 value. So you can just see how the cards started to decline. And it's not like a lot. It's only like a few dollars to each card. So don't think that like, oh, this was 85, dropped to 75. No, it's just each card dropped a few bucks. And that's why. But now we are going to get into the big hitters. The first one we got is a Glaceon V alt art from Evolving Skies. Now this card, oh my goodness, this card has been going up in value. If you remember, this card used to be $40. Now it currently goes for $77.02. So it jumped up like $37. Like, that's pretty nuts. I paid $62 for this. So I got a pretty nice price for this. And Glaceon is my favorite evolution, hands down. A gorgeous alt art. And this was one that I really needed. And I'm trying to get all the evolutions. So really glad to have gotten this gorgeous card. And I think this is a very underrated card that, you know, thankfully is now going up in value. It's past the Leafeon, so that's something. But just looking back there, that town, a lot of people don't pay attention to that. Like, this is a gorgeous fucking card. I don't care what anybody says. But next, we got the Leafeon V alt art to complement the Glaceon V. The Leafeon V is another alt art from Evolving Skies. Currently goes for $63.67. So not as much as the Glaceon. But this card I paid $50 for, which is a pretty nice price, I'd say. Honestly, when it came to getting these two, when they were $40 was when I should have fucking bought it. I didn't have the money at the time, so I was like, damn, I really need to hold off. And when these started jumping up in price, I was just going nuts. When they were hitting 60, 70 bucks, I was like, I really don't think I am willing to pay something, you know, that much for these two. But honestly, 62 and 50 for this, you know, I think that's a fair price where we are at right now. But basically, I think these cards will definitely go down during the summer. I just couldn't wait because I need to have the alt art so badly. And after getting these two, all I need right now is the Sylveon VMAX alt art and the Glaceon VMAX alt art. And I'll have every evolution alt art. So, two more. I know it's going to be like a $300 ordeal, but I'm so close. And then now, the Galarian Moltres V. This is such a gorgeous card in fucking Chilling Rain. That's what this card is from. Currently goes for $126.84. I think it's almost at $130, $135 as of right now, because I kind of wrote down the prices a few days ago. I paid $105 for this card, which is really nice. This card, I think, went down to around like $80, $90, and has bounced back crazily. But that is because the hype of Chilling Rain, everyone thinking that like that set is incredible, which it is an incredible set. All the alt arts, so fucking gorgeous. But I'll tell you, when it comes to this card, to me, this is the best alt art in the whole fucking set. The Blaziken V, which is, or Blaziken V Max alt art, which is the most expensive alt art in Chilling Rain right now, does not compare to the fucking Galarian Moltres V. This is fucking, oh my god. Let it go. Like, look at this. Look at the eyes, the detail. This man is going to just destroy your day, burn down your house, kill your family. Hopefully not, but, you know, you never know. But these three cards alone were just $200 right here, more than that. But really glad to have gotten these cards for an affordable price, I'd say. Going to the final four, we have the Cyndiscorch VMAX. This is a trainer gallery card from Lost Origin. I paid $6.28, and this goes for about $7 on TCG Player. So, you know, again, close to the MSRP price, but it is a really nice card and another card that I needed for my Trainer Gallery set. So, nothing really special to say about that card. Next, we have Peony, another full art from Chilling Rain. Now, this is a really cheap card. I paid $5 for this. It goes for about $6.07. So not an expensive card. I think, you know, months ago, this card was going for about $10. So now it's gone down a little bit. But it's pretty affordable. And again, Chilling Rain, you know, it's a hard set to pull. So I'm getting all the Chilling Rain cards that I need soon. So I don't have to deal with that anymore. And especially since the Sun and Moon era, Sun and Moon, especially since the Sword and Shield era is coming to a close. Next, we have B, and this is a fine fucking woman. Baby, can't you see? Oh my god. Best fucking champion, gym trainer, gym challenger. I don't even know what the fuck to describe B. She's so fucking bad. Dear God, help me. I don't know. Anyways, this is a Trainer Gallery full art from Astral Radiance. I paid $5 for this. This goes for $4.80. So 20 cents cheaper than what I paid for. And honestly, out of all these cards, there is no shit pick of the month. I keep saying shit pick of the week in every video. It's shit pick of the month. And there has been none, because most of these cards I've gotten for good prices or close to MSRP. So there really hasn't been a card that disappoints too much. And even if this card was worth a buck, B is still one sexy ass bitch. So I don't mind overspending for B. But finally, we are down to our last and final card. You can kind of see quality is a little eh with some whitening on the sides, but nevertheless, still a gorgeous centering and condition. We have Team Magma's Groudon EX. This is from Double Crisis. This is like, I believe, an XY set, and it's a pretty old one. Now, I paid $40 for this. This currently goes for $62.22. So probably the best deal out of every card here that I got was this one right here. Now, the opposite to this one is the Team Aqua's Kyogre EX, and that card in itself is fucking amazing. I have that, so this completes this, like, that set for me, the Double Crisis, because this and the Kyogre were the only two good cards in that whole fucking set. It's a small set, but just glad to have gotten this at a nice cheap price, a gorgeous card at that, and I tell you, this is the most expensive month I've paid for Pokemon cards. You can kind of see, oh, over top in this look. I spent a total of $366 this month. That is a pretty, pretty penny to spend on Pokemon cards in one fucking month. But all these cards I got, you know, I definitely think it was worth it. I'm so glad to have bought all these and to add them for my collection. It just shows how much I really like Pokemon. Like, to me, I would never get rid of any of these cards, sell any of these cards. These are from my collection. You know, I think these are going to go up in value, which is why I buy these. They are my favorite types. Trainer galleries, alt arts, full arts. These are my favorite types of cards, and my money says that these cards will go up in value. So, as always, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this monthly pickups of January. A lot of cards, a lot of expensive cards. Didn't think I'd be spending this much, but when you're fucking addicted to Pokemon like me, you drop the money. So, but really excited to have all these cards. And I'll tell you, most of these cards I got were on Discord, Facebook groups. I'll tell you, I posted some stuff on like what cards I wanted into a bunch of different groups, how much I was willing to pay. And oh my goodness, I got fucking humiliated, attacked. People were like, oh, you think you can just get this card for this amount when it's really worth this? What a joke. So when you try to find cards for a good price, it can be really tough and you can get harassed big time. So just be prepared if you're willing to do that. But I'll tell you, throughout the harassment and shit like that, I still found sellers that were willing to sell their cards to me for the price I asked. So I'll probably be doing another video on stuff like that, the Pokemon community when it comes to the market and buying cards and selling cards and how people react to this kind of stuff. So just another interesting video I guess I could make. But as always, thanks again. Hope you enjoyed the video. And let's exit with another shot of my beautiful cock. It's getting late, but I don't mind. It's getting late, but I don't mind.